A very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So as we know, in the biology session we are learning about reproduction in plants. So today in this session we are going to discuss about one of the more interesting topic or one of the most interesting point from the lesson, that is we are going to discuss about fertilization. Okay, so let's start to discuss what is mean by exactly fertilization. So in our previous video we have discussed about the male sex gamete and the female sex gamete. What is the male sex gamete? Male sex gamete means what? Pollen grain. While the female sex gamete means what? Ovules, which are present in the ovary. And where are the pollen grains are present? Pollen grains are present in the anther. Okay. So the fusion of the male and the female gamete, that process is called as what? Fertilization. Okay. So the fusion of the male and the female sex gamete, that process is called as what? Fertilization. So let's discuss how exactly the pollen grain from the anther reaches to the ovary in the ovary and get mixed with the ovules. Okay. So as we know, we have seen about the pollination process. Okay. So because of that pollination, what happens? The anthers or the pollen grain from the anther reaches to the stigma. So when the pollen grain reaches to the stigma, that pollen grain started to rise one tube or started to produce one tube, which we are calling as what? Pollen tube. Okay, they started to produce one pollen tube which moves downward only. Okay, which moves downward only, and that pollen tube penetrates the stigma. That penetrates the stigma. Also, it penetrates the style. Okay. So the pollen grain when lands on the stigma, they started to produce the pollen tube. Then that pollen tube penetrate means what? They penetrate, they pass through the stigma and then they moves or then they runs along with the style. Okay, this is what style, this is what stigma and style. And then it moves through the side and then it get opens into the ovary. Okay, it get opens into the ovary. Okay. So as we know, this pollen grain contains what? Male sex gamete, or the pollen grains means what? Male sex gamete. So after that, once this pollen grain comes into the ovary, but how it comes? The pollen grain started to appear as the pollen tube that penetrates the stigma, runs through the style, and along with that pollen tube, that pollen grain burst into the ovary. And as we know, in the ovary there are the already ovules. Okay, there are the already ovules. So in this way, ovules and the pollen grain can get fused, and then they forms the one new cell, which we are calling as what? Zygote. Okay, which we are calling as what? Zygote. Okay, so see here, this is the formation of zygote. Now you understood how the pollen grain transferred to the ovary along with the pollen tube. The pollen grain, once it reaches to the stigma, they started to produce the pollen tube. That pollen tube always runs towards the downward and it penetrates the stigma. Also it runs through the style and it get directly open into the ovary only. Okay, it get directly open into the ovary. So along with that pollen grain, the pollen tubes, along with that pollen tube, the pollen grains comes in the ovary, and in the ovary there are the already ovules. So in this way, the fusion of the ovules and the pollen grain takes place and then forms the one new cell, which is called as what? Zygote. So then zygote started to grow and then it forms what? Embryo. Then it forms what? Embryo. Okay, just so this zygote to start to get grow, these zygote start to get developed, and then it forms what? Embryo. Okay, so this is what? The fusion of the male and the female sex gamete. It is called as what? Fertilization. Okay, that process is called as fertilization. So after this fertilization, what happened? So after this fertilization, there is a production of the fruits. Okay. So once the reproduction, or once this fertilization takes place, so after fertilization there are the several changes takes place in the flower. The ovary started to get increase in the size. Okay, the ovary started to get increase in the size, and slowly slowly it get converts into the fruit. Okay, so the fruit is nothing but what? Ripened ovary. Fruit is nothing but what? Ripened ovary. And what about the ovules which are present in the ovary? And then that ovules get converts into the seeds. Okay, the ovules get converted into the seed, and ripened ovary get converted into the ovules get converted into the seed, and that seed contains the embryo within it, which embryo if we do that germination process in the soil, then that embryo started to grow, and in this way we are giving the new, or we can produce the new plant from the seed. Okay, so this is all about what sexual reproduction in a plant. But we have seen the different fruits. Okay, there are the certain fruits which are very fleshy and which are very juicy. For example, we can say mango, apple. Okay, all these are fruits are very fleshy. But on the other hand, there are the certain fruits which are very hard. For example, especially we can say the nuts are there. Walnuts is there, almonds is there. Okay, so all these are the nuts are very hard. Okay, so in this way, this is about fruit is nothing but what ripened ovary, and ovules are the seeds which are present in the fruit. Okay, so this is all about fertilization. Now, once the seed get developed, then as we know, this seed is used to produce the different plants. But every time it is not possible to sow the seeds into the soil. There are the certain plants which can grow by their own. But how they can grow by their own? They are growing with the help of the seeds only. But no one is going to sow the seeds in the soil. But how that plants are growing? Yes, that plants are growing with the help of the seeds only. But that seeds can get dispersed. Okay, that seed can get dispersed, can get scattered from one place to another place with the help of the different agents. For example, we can say with the help of the animals, wind, water. Okay, along with that, all the seeds can get moved from the one place to another place. And when the seeds get the proper condition, that is what, which is the proper or the good condition for the germination of the seed, air, water and wind. So when the seed get all these favorable conditions, then the seeds started to get germinate and started to produce the new plant. Okay, so if we talk about the seed germination or the dispersal of the seed, is it required? Yes, obviously it requires. Seed dispersion is helps to scatter the different types of the plants on the different places, which helps to increase the biodiversity. Also, it helps to avoid the competition between the plants for the water, mineral and different nutrients. Okay, so think for a while, if all the seeds are get collected on the one place and all the plants will start to grow at the same place, then what will be happen? Obviously, that plants will not get the enough nutrients, water, minerals and sunlight also. There will be the big competition in the plants for the sunlight, water and the nutrients. So all these plants will not get the enough water, nutrients and the sunlight, and possibility is that they will not grow properly. So avoid all these things. There is a very necessity of the seed dispersion. Okay, so if we talk about the seeds which get dispersed with the help of the wind, then that seeds are very light in the way and they are having the feather like structures on them. Okay, along with that, they can easily move. Okay, so these are the certain seeds which can move along with the wind. Next one, we can say that the seeds which can move with the help of the water, disperse with the help of the water. Very well known example, we can say that coconut. So the specially the seeds which can get dispersed with the help of the water, these seeds are having the fibrous coating over it. With the help of that fibrous coating, they can easily move along with that water stream. Now we'll go through the next one, that is the seed can get dispersed with the help of the animals also. And the seeds which get dispersed with the help of the animals, their seeds are having specially hooks like structures on them. Along with that hooks, what happen? That hooks get attached to the body of the animals and the human beings. And in this way, they can get dispersed from the one place to another place. For example, you can see that xanthium. Okay, xanthium is the seed which is having this hook like structure and can get dispersed with the help of the animals. And the last one is there are the certain seeds which can get explored. Okay, or because of the explosion, what happen? The seeds get dispersed. For example, we can say the castor is there or the green peas are there. So all these fruits are getting dry up, and because of the certain force, that seeds or that pods of the plant get explode. Okay, and the seeds comes out, that we are calling as what? Bursting process. So this is all about today. This is what the certain ways for the dispersion of the seed, and the last one is what? Explosion. Okay, explosion is what? The suddenly the seeds are coming out from the fruit. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the fertilization. Also, we have discussed about the dispersion of the seeds. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here, and also we have completed this lesson today. So here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.